In 1976, Van der Graaf Generator were riding high on their second wind, releasing two albums that year. And from their sixth studio album, Still Life, the opening track, Pilgrims.
Sometimes you feel so far away, distanced from all the action.
Okay, basically, so far we've got this, like, swelling intro from Hugh Banton, and then we are led, like, right into the first verse, and also, like, just a slight bit of flute there from David Jackson amid Hammill's vocals.
Able to grasp significance, marking the plot with diffident dismay.
Wow, that's quite, he's holding his notes quite well. Notice how Hammill's vocal melody is kind of mimicking the organ line. Hammill has improved as a vocalist in the years since, like, the first coming of Van der Graaf. He,
unsure of the dream.
I'm really impressed by how he's holding those vowels out, like stretching them out, and seemingly without, and it doesn't sound forced either. It sounds to be just kind of like oozing right out of them. Okay, the I really like how Hugh Banton was starting to add a bit more filigree into the lines. He was playing a bit faster. He wasn't quite he was kind of like doing his, like, playing ahead almost of Hammill on some of the last couple of bars that we heard. Let's catch up with the lyrics, because a lot of words are passing by here. Sometimes you feel so far away, distanced from all the action of the play. Unable to grasp significance, marking the plot with diffident dismay. Stranded at center stage, scrabbling through your diary for a lost page. I believe action of the play is just kind of a metaphor for life in general. Unsure of the dream, kicking a stone across the beach. That's an interesting metaphor. I'll reserve my interpretations. Aching for love and comfort out of reach. The way ahead seems to be so bleak. There's no one with any friendship left to speak or show you any relation between your present and future situations. Lost to the dream. So far, what I'm taking it is that the way I'm interpreting this is that this person has kind of gone so far on their own kind of idiosyncratic journey that they're having a hard time relating to others, and it seems as though the window of time in which they could possibly form an important lifelong bond with someone is, they're becoming just too set in their ways to make that kind of change in life at this point.
Oh, yeah. Any relation between your present and future situations.
Showing his range as a vocalist, you know, going into those upper. Okay, you know that, you can tell that something's about to happen here. The way that Guy Evans is doing those kind of muted roles that are just sort of brimming with possibility. The way he's stretching it out, it's hard to like pause while he does. He really fills out each. He rarely lets go. There aren't many. Like I keep on trying to like wait for moments when he's like, you know, paused for a moment, but they're rare. I had to comment on that kind of icier tone that Banton is giving us right here. That fuller kind of churchy tone. Yeah, he mostly sticks to organ, it seems. I'm hearing like lots of like thick, like Hammond organ on this album. And I think he primarily just stuck to organ. He didn't really get into the newer synthesizers or okay, the old Hammill is back. And he's doing this kind of growl with a bit more confidence, and it just seems to be coming out more naturally now. He actually sounds like, I wonder what some of the vocal coaches on YouTube would have to say if any of them. I would like to hear like Ken Tamplin's you know, thoughts on Hammill. That low note they throw in here, there's a certain kind of depth to the keys, to the tonal feel right here. I'm hearing like a B and an F sharp at the same time. I think it's like F sharp with a suspended third. Walking in silence down the coast, merely to journey, we hope is the most. Okay, now we're back to the verse again, but it's a bit more involved this time. There's a bit more urgency going on. To know there is an end, all of us lovers, brothers, sisters, friends. Well, the big difference, I guess, here is that Guy Evans is now involved. Okay, let's catch up with the lyrics. A lot has passed by here. Away, away, look to the future day for hope, some form of peace within the growing storm. I kind of wonder how lyrics and music were put together by this band. Like, were lyrics written separately, independent of even knowing about the music? Because sometimes it does seem like these verses seem, oftentimes in Van der Graaf Generator songs, seem rather wordy. I'm wondering if Hammill just writes poetry and then brings it to the band or something, or... I know that, like, one example I can think of writing like that was in the band Squeeze, where I think Chris Difford wrote all these lyrics separately of Glenn Tilbrook, who would separately write the music, and then they would bring their ideas to the table and try to find which lyrics worked with which verses, which melodies, which bars and such. And consequently, there were times when certain verses seemed rather wordy, rather stuffed, because they were trying to take this pre-existing set of lyrics and put it to this kind of this set of music. Away, away, look to the future day for hope, some form of peace within the growing storm. I climb through the evening alive and breathing in time. We shall all know our goals, and so finally home. For now, all is secret, though how could I speak it? Allow me the dream in my eye. I've been waiting for such a long time, just to see it at last. All the hands tightly clasped. All of us pilgrims. I'm getting kind of a similar vibe to Plague of Lighthouse Keepers. Once again, that imagery of a lonely figure, like on a stormy beach or something, or by the water, or like at night, like that whole like lonely figure, and you know, in under thunder and lightning, and yeah, a haunted, tortured soul type. Walking in silence down the coast, merely to journey, here hope is the most. Yeah, the whole coastal setup has been kind of well established in earlier lyrics. Merely to know there is an end, all of us lovers, brothers, sisters, friends, hand in hand, shining footprints on the wet sand, lead to the dream. The time has come, the tide has almost run, and drained the deep. I rise from lifelong sleep. Okay, I'll save the rest for a bit later. I wonder if these... I'm wondering if they're kind of stretching it out just a little bit. I think that this could have been tightened up a little bit. Hearing it the first time had me kind of like anticipating, you know, and of course I've listened to this album, so you know, I've known this album for 26 years, but like just following it really closely and following each development closely, like the first time I was thinking, yeah, was it worked, but the second time I'm thinking, I'm getting a sense that they're just kind of being a little bit long-winded. Yeah. I think once was enough, maybe, of this section. And we don't need, like, what is it, like... Maybe they should have cut the first few bars of this second bridge out, and then just gone to this where he's adding a little bit different from last time. He's adding that overarching sustain vocal. From life, long sleep. It seems such a long time. Yeah, he actually sounds like. Like he's learned how to incorporate that kind of vocal technique of his into a more natural singing style. Notice how like Guy Evans is giving this really stately precision to things, but Hugh Banton keeps laying out these like really thick, sustained, like kind of like walls of like organ. this, it has like this big, like rising giant wall of sound, and it's all because of Banton. Okay, let's catch up with the lyrics here. It seems such a long time I've dreamed, but now awake I can see we are pilgrims and so must walk this road. Unknown in our purpose, alone but not worthless, and home ever calling us on. Oh, we've been waiting here for so long, all our hands joined in hope, holding the weight on the rope. All of us pilgrims. I am not so certain whether this is actually about pilgrims or if pilgrimage is just sort of a metaphor for kind of the loneliness that comes with just taking the road less traveled. I was trying to avoid using that phrase, but that kind of just existential theme that runs through a lot of Peter Hammill's lyrics. Finally, we're going to get to hear a bit more of David Jackson. Somewhat underrepresented on this track. I am just so taken by the thickness and just volume of that organ. It just fills up so much. Just one guy alone, like one hand, one or two hands, just creating all this sonic thickness, fullness, volume. Really does have kind of more of a 1971 sound, largely due to Hugh Banton's choice of, it says that he uses a Mellotron on this album. Here I'm just hearing organ. Oh, and he uses a pedalboard. It says bass pedals. I guess he's maybe like playing like a sustain bass on that with his foot while just holding down keys on that Hammond. I'm hearing a little bit of bass notes in here now. Boom, 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 boom. Like... There hasn't been like a lot of soloing in this. In fact, hardly any. It seems like notice how in this passage, David Jackson, his sax part has been just kind of sticking to the same melody as emphasized by like the organ and that Peter Hammill had been singing, kind of mimicking with his vocal lines. Graaf Generator with Pilgrims from their 1976 album Still Life, their sixth album, and their second after reforming the prior year. and their first of two albums to be released in 1976. Later that year, they would release the album World Record. And, yeah. And having basically just picked up this and the prior album, God Bluff, just picking up where they had left off, basically, on Pawn Hearts, back in 71. And with a sound very much, unchanged through, at this point, half-decade time frame. Musically sounding a lot like Frumpy or Eilef. Yeah, like one of those, German, symphonic hard rock bands of the early 1970s with the thick, Hammond organ and sax and such. Anyway, and I am open to other interpretations of these lyrics. I don't know if they've really been discussed elsewhere. Let's see. Oh, bringing it up on genius.com. Did anyone comment? Oh, no one did. Anyway, for more rubies and sapphires from the catalog of Van der Graaf Generator, see the directory of albums by English V artists linked in the description below. For Red Hot Tracks and Purples from all of the Van der Graaf Generator albums from 1969, The Aerosol Gray Machine, to 1977, The Quiet Zone, The Pleasure Zone, as well as their 1978 album, Live Double Album Vital. And from there, go on to the P directory in the A to Z English album directory to see Peter Hammill's solo albums and Red Tracks and Purples from those. Yeah, all of his solo albums from 1971 through 1990, anyway. And, hit the L directory to see the albums by the Long Hello, the project by some of the other members that they did, between different periods of activity by the band. Like and subscribe and follow me on social media and leave a comment if there are any observations you have about this song, the layers, the thickness, the instrumentation, the interplay, the vocals, and I guess most importantly, the lyrics. Interested what some other interpretations of those words would be. And until next time, this is Zaragon, the world's most ear-troubled trim maximalist, signing off.